What is that? Are you serious? Son of a.
Are you team underhand serve or team no way for the underhand serve? Well, regardless of what you think, I will tell you that Roger Federer, when asked about when Kyrgios hit his underhand serve against Rafa in that match, he said he thinks it's a very viable tactic that should be used when your opponent is way back behind the baseline. And that the problem is that most people don't practice it. And so it's really hard to pull out when there's crowds and in big match play situations. So today, whether you're on one side or the other, we're gonna show you the steps to be able to pull out the underhand serve when you need it for your next match. All right, so let's get into it. So say you want to use an underhand serve. There are certain specific things that you need to look for and that you need to work on and practice so that you can be able to use it in those match play situations. The first thing is that when you're hitting an underhand serve, there actually is spin on the ball. Your goal is to make the ball spin away from your opponent. So if you're right-handed, which I am, and if you're left-handed, you'll do the opposite. But I'm going to make sure that my racket is moving from the right to the left in my swing path under the ball. I do want to have, it's like a backspin with side spin on the ball. So when I hit the ball, it's going to curve that direction away from my opponent, down the center of the court or into their body if I'm going out wide. The whole goal of the underhand serve is to mix things up. And so if you're just doing this and letting the ball pop off your strings, you're giving them an opportunity to have a short ball and be able to really attack the ball. But really what you want to do is be able to put spin and make them have to do something with the ball. It's a surprise tactic that can become very useful, and it lands pretty short and stays really low. So if Ian is way far back, then it can be very viable for me to throw one in and him have to really run after it and lunge to hit the next ball. So again, you're looking at having your continental grip racket face open, so your strings are going to be facing up, and your movement's going to be across the ball with your swing path from right to left. Your goal is to have a really relaxed grip. If you're super tense, you're not going to be able to get very much on the ball. If you're really relaxed, you're actually going to have like a little lag in your racket as you're hitting, and that's really where the whip is coming from. Now, if you're in a match play situation and you're really looking to disguise this shot, because that's obviously what Kyrgios does and why it was so effective against Rafa, is that you're going to do the same thing, but there's a couple little things that make it to where Ian can't see that that's what I'm going to do. So when I come up to the line and I'm getting ready, my feet are in the same position, I have my continental grip, and I'm getting ready to serve. When I'm in a forward motion, my weight is forward, that's the best time to do it before you start your swing path. And you're going to want to actually keep your head down, because if you move your head up, you're gonna end up making a lot more errors on the underhand serve. And my movement from right to left with my swing path is actually gonna be minimized so that I'm not telegraphing it to Ian. If he sees my racket going up, then he knows that I'm going to hit an underhand serve. But if I'm in this motion and then I just throw it in there, then it's actually going to be a lot more disguised and harder for him to be able to anticipate, which is going to make it much more effective in your next match.